who was Eric as a kid? I know that, you know, your life centered around football, but was that always you? Talk about Eric the kid for a second.
Eric the kid, you know, grew up, you know, in an area where there were a lot of kids in the suburbs of New Jersey. I always say I'm the last generation of the kids that used to go outside, go to the park, stay up from the sunlight till sundown generation. You know, before now everyone's inside, you know, playing video and this and that. I was an outside kid. I moved from an apartment building when I was Bornington, and I moved to a house with my mom, my dad at the time, and my sister when I was 5 years old. And, you know, I had three other kids on the block with me, two my age, another about 5 years older than us. And we always used to play this game called kill the man with the ball on the side of the house. And of course, the guy 5 years older than us would throw us, or he would throw us into the house, throw us into the fence. You know, he would get rough with us. But every now and then, I would juke him out and get past him and score a touchdown. And that adrenaline rush from when I was 4 or 5 years old led me to playing the game of football and starting my football journey.
Beautiful, beautiful. Okay, so as we dive deeper into your story, I know, because just doing my research on you, I know that your mom is always there with you. Mm-hmm. Give me the family dynamic. Number one, is your dad still around? I heard you just mention him. You just mentioned that you have a sister. Are there any brothers in the picture? How many kids are in your household to begin with?
So I grew up, my dad moved out to the next town over from me, to Carteret, New Jersey, when I was 5 years old. And my dad was in the picture of my life growing up. I always say, whatever I needed, he was there for me. Coming to my games, he was present. He was definitely mm-hmm. present. But my mom raised me. My mom raised me and turned me into the man that I am today. It was my sister, who's 11 years older than me, my mom and myself. That's how I grew up. My sister, when I was 7 years old, went to North Carolina A&T State University down in Greensboro, North Carolina. And it was my mom and I in the house from, you know, 7 till I was 11 years old. My sister moved back in. So, I grew up in the time where you go outside and play. So my mom was always on me, making sure, you know, that I was outside. I was, you know, doing the right things, grooming me the right way, trying to, you know, mold me into a young black male who's going to, you know, into this world with some sort of disadvantages sometimes. But she always told me, Eric, don't ever look at it like that. Go out there and be who you are. You respect everybody. I don't care if they're the CEO or the janitor. I don't care if they're white or black. You become a respectable young man, because if you do that, you'll see that people will have your back. And that's what I learned.
That's so nice. That's such a great lesson. And I'm sure that followed you onto the football field. You said that you started playing football very early age. Were you somebody who played throughout high school? Were you somebody who played just in leagues in the neighborhood?
Yeah, so there's a Pop Warner. I started when I was 5 years old, flag football. And I played for the Port Reading Saints through the Pop Warner League all the way up until I got to high school. I got to play the last three games of varsity in my high school football, and because we had an injury on the team, I got bumped up. And I'm not going to lie to you, I balled out. Had 45 tackles in three games. And next thing you know, I'm getting a scholarship offer to Rutgers University as a freshman in college. So from there, you know, the only regret I always say in high school, I wish I played baseball and basketball all 4 years. After my freshman year, I stopped playing baseball and basketball, and I focused on football and getting myself ready, because mama knew that's where the scholarship was. That's where the money was. That's how you get to go to college for free. So let's focus on that.
You know, you are synonymous with Rutgers football. Mm-hmm. Everything from your logo, you know, we can't see totally behind you, but I see your jersey and you have the Rutgers there. Let's talk, you going to Rutgers, playing for the team. Were you automatically a standout? Did you start automatically? Was it a huge transition coming from high school ball to college ball?
Oh, it was a big transition. I'll tell you what. I got recruited to play one position, came there, met my goal weight. They wanted, I was 6'2". They wanted me at 232 pounds. I come there to play linebacker, thought I was going to move there. In high school, I was a little bit bigger. I played at like 240, 250. So Rutgers knew, like, you know what? That kid got some size to him. He can grow. That's not holding him back. I didn't know this at the time. But they moved me to nose guard, which is down in the trenches with the big boys, 300-plus pound dudes. down there, you know, 6'5", 6'6", 6'7". And now they move me, 6'2", 232 pounds, into the trenches with the big dogs. I never played down there in my life. Talk about a transition.
What year were you in when you made this transition? Around. So,
my freshman, this was right off the jump.
Wow.
So Coach Schiano threw me right into the fire. And I had to learn how to survive down there. And I didn't redshirt my freshman year. I found a home on special teams where I made a big impact on kickoff, kickoff return, all that stuff. And then I was finding my way onto the field here and there in these new positions and playing in front of 60, 70, 80,000 people. And it was a huge transition, but I got thrown right into the fire. And that's how you learn, you know. You get thrown into the fire, you're going to get burned or you're going to find a way to make it happen. And I was thankful enough. I got burned a few times. I ain't going to lie. But at the end of the day, I found a way to happen.
Okay, so were you a kind of person who you just accepted this challenge? Like, I understand this is not my normal position. I understand this is not what you guys brought me here for. But if you see something in me, I'm just going to rise up and accept this. Or did you, like most people, be like, this ain't the position I'm supposed to be playing. I'm going, you know, buck up against it. What was your attitude with even switching positions, especially going up against 300-pound men?
Oh, I'm so glad you asked that question. I didn't like it at all. I was like, what's? I'm 17 years old now. I'm like, what's Coach talking about? Like, he's moving me here. I never played it down in my life with my hand in the ground. Then in the second week of the season, our second string defensive end was another position on the defensive line, just out a little bit more, got hurt. They bumped me over there. So I started playing, learning this whole new position middle of the season. So now another injury, our offense decided we weren't productive at fullback. They bumped me over to offense, and I'm playing fullback now. And I got to learn that terminology. I stayed there for 3 weeks. Then they bumped me back to defensive end, and then at the end of the year, they moved me back to nose guard. And Shawn, I said to myself, do I love this game anymore? I did. Like, this was one of the hardest football I've ever had. I never been like this. This football has always been so easy to me. Come to Zoe, I got put in positions, and I go out there and excel. This year challenged me. And I said, I remember I had a meeting with my coach at the end of the year. And I said, Coach, like what's going on? Like, this was not my plan for my career. He said, listen, Eric, you're going to learn in life, love is sacrifice. We trusted you to put you in those positions to go out there and get the job done. Do you think I would have put you out there if I didn't think that you could go out there and get the job done? Yes, I know it wasn't easy. Yes, I know it wasn't fun. But I challenged you, and you overcame that adversity, and you became a better person. You're now mentally stronger to be able to deal with transitions like this. And I remember being that now 18-year-old boy, like, you know what? You're right, Ian. He goes, you'll learn, E. When you love something so much, sometimes you're going to have to sacrifice a lot of things and a lot of things that you thought were going to go your way or this was planned in order for the bigger plan. And you got to put your trust in us. And he was right. After that, I bulked up, started gaining weight, and I found my home down there.
Okay. Eric, I don't think you realize, or maybe you do, the gems that you just dropped. Yeah. I want to go backwards for a second because I didn't realize that this was the answer you were going to give me. When you went in and you're frustrated, you just came off a very difficult season. Mm-hmm. And you sit down and you talk to your coach. Coach, what are you doing? This is not what I came here for. Can you repeat back to me and the audience? Because everybody needs to hear exactly what you just said, because sometimes we're put in these positions in life and it's not what we signed up for. But truth be told, it's the path that we need to go to get to our ultimate destination. And that's where trusting the process comes in at. But more important, in your case, there was somebody who saw something in you that maybe at the time you didn't see in yourself. So can you just take this back for 1 second? Because I want to drive this point home. So anybody who's listening to this on iTunes, Spotify, or any of the streaming services, or watching this on YouTube, please listen up to this conversation once again. Eric.
Yes, going to that meeting with coaching, not knowing where my career is going to go. And he talked to me man to man, eye to eye, and said, listen, Eric, you're going to learn love is sacrifice. This may not have been the plan that you had that was in store for you. But I wouldn't have put you out there if I didn't think that you could be trusted to get the job done. I could have put anybody else out there, but I picked you in every single one of those positions because I trusted you to learn the position, get the job done. Yes, it wasn't always easy, and it wasn't always fun, and you got thrown into the fire, and sometimes you got burned. But guess what? You're now mentally strong enough to be able to deal with this. You're going to get bigger. You're going to get stronger, and you're going to understand this position, and you got to learn to trust us in order to get the job done and learn that love is sacrifice. And that's what you just did.
What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.